Welcome to Jung Tuition. I am Jung. Guess what? I have been recently chatting with Grok and Musk's xAI on humans' understanding of mass or matter, or in short, what is matter? In particular, my first question is, modern physics fails to explain what mass is. Do you agree? I am going to discuss this chat today because it demonstrates some limitations of modern physics I identified over 40 years ago. Are you ready? Let's go and have fun. Here is a summary of his answer. Modern physics, particularly through the framework of the Standard Model and general relativity, provides explanation for mass, though some aspects remain under active research and debate. Apparently, the AI knows well the two relevant fields right away, namely the Standard Model based on quarks and Einstein relativity based on redefinition of time. Then it went on. The reconciliation of quantum mechanics with general relativity, where concepts like mass need to be explained in a unified theory, remains one of the biggest challenges in physics. Theories like string theory or loop quantum gravity attempt to address this, but are not yet experimentally verified. It continues. While modern physics gives us significant insights into the nature of mass, particularly through the Higgs mechanism, there are still unresolved questions, especially regarding the dark matter and the unification of quantum mechanics with gravity. Can you see? The AI cannot go out of that loop. I don't think this AI would admit the fact in his answer. That I wouldn't say modern physics fails to explain mass, but rather that's an area of ongoing research and development, as expected. Then I wrote, the Higgs mechanism is required by the Standard Model to gain mass phenomenologically, but the mass here is treated as equivalent to interactions which cannot be directly observed. Here is answer. Phenomenologically, the Higgs mechanism provides an elegant explanation for why particles have mass. It's a theoretical framework that predicts how particles should behave in terms of mass acquisition. However, this mass is indeed an emergent property of these interactions. Notice, the AI used the popular word emerge that has been often used for studying a complex system such as a condensed matter. Then he explains, the mass we measure or observed in experiments isn't the interaction itself, but the effect of its interaction. We don't directly see particles interacting with the Higgs field. I know. The Higgs mechanism was invoked in light of the P.W.Anderson's idea of local symmetry breaking, which is a mathematical trick to fix the fundamental problems of the Standard Model, isn't it? The AI response, the Higgs mechanism is indeed based on the concept of spontaneously symmetry breaking, which was mathematically articulated by P.W.Anderson and others. This concept was crucial for explaining how particles acquired mass without violating the symmetries inherent in the fundamental forces. While you describe this as a mathematical trick, it's perhaps more accurate to say it's a mathematical tool or framework. Mathematics in physics often serves as a language to describe or model physical phenomena that we observed or predict. I interrupted the AI by saying, return to my original question. Mass is tangible, but it cannot be explained without redefining basic concepts in physics, such as mass is equivalent to energy, mass from interactions, and so on and so forth. But in reality, nobody knows what mass without invoking mathematical language, which is not physics. The AI replied, "The idea that mass comes from interactions with fields challenges our intuitive understanding. It's not that mass is something in the classical sense, but rather that it emerges from how particles interact with the underlying structure of the universe." Notice the AI used the word emerge again. Obviously, this AI was trained by using the current consensus on this basic issue. As an individual, it would appear too difficult to change its mind. But I want to give a trial. I remarked, "Do you mean it took over 2,000 years for physicists to rediscover the Platonic sonnets describing in the element by Euclid?" The Platonic sonnets were appreciated more for their mathematical beauty and symmetry rather than any direct physical significance, though they were linked to metaphysical concepts. Today, symmetry plays a crucial role in modern physics, especially in quantum field theories. The symmetry of Platonic sonnets are echoed in the symmetries of the particle interactions, though at the more abstract level. Some versions of the string theory propose that the universe might have extra unseen dimensions, and certain models suggest these dimensions could have shapes akin to higher dimensional analogs of the Platonic sonnets. However, this is highly theoretical and speculative. Further, the AI added, "It's more accurate to say that physicists have reinterpreted or found new applications for the concepts of symmetry and geometry embodied by Platonic sonnets, rather than rediscovered them in the same form." What is the takeaway from this chat? The mass is a kind of emerging effect due to some abstract symmetry breakings, which has been the consensus over the past 60 years. Hence, nobody knows what mass is without invoking one or more hypotheses. This is just one example for what I called the linguistic limits in physics over 40 years ago, which I can discuss further. Thank you for your watching and support. Please make your little bell activated so that you wouldn't miss any of my new talks. See you next time.